This bowl of compostable bioplastic developed at Murdoch University is being turned into items like straws and cutlery, leaving behind zero microplastics. But why does that matter? If you were to pick any item produced in the last decade, you can almost guarantee that plastic was involved in the process. This is because each year, over 400 million tons of plastic is produced, but only 9% of that actually gets recycled. Instead, plastic is spread across the globe, turning into microplastics that last for decades, causing countless issues in our environment. But why is plastic so popular if it's causing so much damage?
One of the reasons that we generate billions and billions of tons of these plastics that have lasted decades is it's an extremely useful product.
When you picture plastic pollution, often what comes to mind is single-use products like bottles, cups, and straws. But it's actually used everywhere, from food packaging, construction, agriculture, and pretty much every industry on the planet. It's obvious plastic isn't sustainable, but essential to society. So what's the solution? It turns out the answer might be found in nature.
We're finding microbes that can do weird and wonderful things out there. And in this case, some of them are making some pretty cool bioplastics.
Bioplastics might be the answer to the plastic crisis, but how is it different? And what will it take to make a sustainable plastic not just a dream, but a reality? Most plastics produced today are made from petroleum, where crude oil is transformed into polymers to create plastic products. This plastic is made of long chains of polymers that are chemically and structurally different from materials that naturally occur, making them resistant to being broken down by the environment. Natural materials, like food waste, are broken down by bacteria, fungi, and other decomposers. But these microorganisms can't digest the strong carbon bonds in synthetic plastic. But what if we could change that? It turns out there are microorganisms found in nature that produce a natural plastic material, and a team of researchers have worked out how to recreate that process.
The Bioplastics Innovation Hub, based at Murdoch University, is a joint collaboration between CSIRO, Murdoch University, and our industry partners. We have a major research and development program on developing compostable bioplastics, and that means they're leaving no legacy in terms of land or water.
Legacy is when plastic breaks down into tiny fragments, but this happens over decades. This is because plastic is made of long chains of synthetic molecules that, rather than breaking down naturally, are designed to last indefinitely. But that's where bioplastic is different. Microbes produce a plastic material called PHB, a natural polymer that is broken down in nature. These microbes turn carbon sources into the individual cells that make up the plastic chains.
And what happens when we're feeding excess carbon sources into the cell? It stores it in these little granules, and what we can do, we can explode those cells and then use those granules for bioplastic production.
We basically process those microbes, take out the little bit that's stored in billions and billions and billions of them, and then we can process that into a polymer or a bioplastic.
After being extracted, PHB is turned into powder, pellets, and eventually plastic. But turning microbes into materials isn't as easy as it may sound.
One of the challenges with producing bioplastics for different applications is that they are processed very differently to traditional plastics. So we often have to implement novel techniques to transform them into the materials that we need. On this machine, you put these beads in there and it heats it and mixes it so you can create a stable mixture of polymers and additives.
From there, it is dissolved in different chemical solvents to produce a film that looks and feels like plastic, but behaves very differently in the environment.
They can be used in the same applications that plastics are, except they are biodegradable. And in the environment, that means that they fully break down into natural components.
Unlike traditional plastic ending up in landfill, this bioplastic breaks down naturally, leaving no trace of microplastics. So if bioplastics are so promising, why haven't we switched over already?
This is the biggest challenge that we are facing at the moment, is scaling up.
Plastic is a well-established technology, produced all over the globe. For bioplastics to replace plastic, they need to be produced at an industrial scale. But scaling up isn't just about making more, it's about making it right.
every scale up, we face different challenges. Every scale up, the bug behaves differently. We have to change all the parameters around the bug so that it can give us a consistent quality production. Otherwise, it will always vary.
So sometimes those scaling up issues can be easy, where you can solve them in 6 months, a year. Sometimes those scaling up issues can be very hard or even insurmountable sometimes. So there's a reason that a lot of these technologies, you might hear about them early on, they talk about technology readiness levels.
Technology readiness levels, originally developed by NASA, tracks how close a technology is to being market ready. It uses a scale to represent the different development stages from 1 through to 9. The first three are taking an idea from an interesting discovery to producing it in the lab, and the last three is when it scales up to an industrial level.
And those steps in between that 4, 5, 6, they often refer to it as the Valley of Death because it is very hard to scale from lab to industry and pilot. All well and good when you've got a single colony, if you've got a single spec, looks great. I scale it up to maybe only like a 5 mil, 50 mils of liquid. Does it still produce it? What are the conditions that it might produce it? And then scaling up again to the 1 liter, further to 10 liters into our bioreactors and now into the industrial scale, as you might see behind me.
Right now, the team are flying high above that valley of death, but scaling up isn't the only issue.
What do we make it from? We don't want to just create the same problems, the same cycle of issues again, where we're taking fresh water away from vulnerable communities, especially with the growing issues around climate change. And we don't want to be turning food crops and food areas away from being able to feed the population that we do. So instead, we're looking at waste inputs, waste yeasts from brewing, waste biodiesel. There's a lot of glycerol and things in that. And instead of using that fresh water, we're using seawater, we're using briny waters so that people who live in coastal communities, if this technology spreads and they're allowed to make the biopolymers locally, they're not having to take away from their own freshwater sources, their own food supply.
But the biggest problem of all is who pays for it?
So industry interest is very important for a research facility because it is where the money comes from. It is where the products will go, which will in the end reach the consumers. I know there's a big appetite for these kind of products, but we just have to produce them at a scale and make them cost efficient for the industries to be able to adapt.
With the support from industry, government, and the public, bioplastics can change the world for the better. While it might still be years before we see bioplastics taking over the market, the future of plastic isn't synthetic. It's natural, sustainable, and already in motion.
Science is hard. Science is being able to accept failure. Not failure on a big scale, but every day coming in and seeing, did it work? Did my idea pan out? Because if it was easy, it'd be done by now. Success will look like people getting their straws back.